Hello guys, si Keshan Vlasol dito at welcome sa episode 15 ng laro tayo ng Deponia The Complete Journey. So game, continue natin yung adventure natin. Pasaway kasi talaga si Rufus eh. Gumawa na naman siya ng gulo pa. Gumawa na naman kalukuan. Kaya nag-discrasya na naman si Goal. So, load. Nung natapos tayo guys, sinubukan natin kausapin si Bozo. Sinabi natin siya napuntahan niya yung dati niyang girlfriend. Kaya lang, disgrasya nangyari. So, wala. Patungan na tayo dito. Marketplace. Weapon shop na naman. Balik muna tayo sa map. Balik tayo sa docks. Meron akong naiwan na ano eh, item dito eh. Oh, yan. Yan. Little Venice, industrial area, marketplace. Marketplace. Meron din dito eh, sa mga banda. Tingnan ko lang sandali yung guide na sinusundan ko guys ha, di ko malala kung nasan siya eh. O tama naman yung pinindot ko. Ayun, nakuha. Attack Alley. Dark Alley muna.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Rue refuse. Rue refuse. Rue refuse. Super super diffuse. Hey, you can say what you like about those black market bums, but they have good taste in music.
I think underground, you know, ito sa yung tinitingnan natin, ano yung may pipe dito nang gagaling yung sound.
An out of the way door in a dark alley. I wonder where it leads. It's empty if you don't count all the creepy crawlies. It seems to be a colony of junk crabs. Cute. An out of the way door in a dark alley. I wonder where it leads.
That isn't the secret knock.
Yes, it is.
No, it isn't. The secret knock goes.
You fool. Now you've given it away. Let me in.
First, the knock.
All right. Now can I come in?
No. Wait, I got that wrong. That was the old knock.
What? But
I know, it's a shame we changed it. The old one was much easier to remember. Nevertheless, we're using the new knock now.
And how does it go?
It's a secret.
Oh, darn it.
Patay dito. Pharmacist. Yung houses. Acid ducks.
Great. Hey, hello. What do you mean, bleh, the nerve?
Kasi mo si Rufus di siya makita. Ato. Fine nose.
I've never seen such a snooty door sensor.
Ito yata gagamitin natin dyan. Sinipon. Okay, eh.
Empty, empty except for the bird droppings. There's nothing here but bird droppings. And there's enough of those on Bozo's deck. I didn't have to come here for them.
Dito meron din eh. Pero yun, kuha ko kagad.
The Big Platypus Field Guide, 3rd edition.
Ito mga kamag-anak ni Perry.
Oh, platypus, you are the best. Upon your breast, I'll gladly rest.
Man.
I like your pretty face so well, and your sweet platypussy smell. Into your eyes, I'm fondly gazing. You're not a platypus. Amazing!
Okay, yeah. Matutuwa si, ano, Dr. Doofenshmirtz sa mga yan.
As much as I hate narrow-minded specialists, the hat is pretty cool.
Welcome to Platypus Paradise. What platitudes may I offer you today?
What the heck is this place? Tell me more about these greeting cards. Grab a bus, platypus.
What the heck is this place?
It's a souvenir shop. We have everything a tourist could possibly desire. Platypus greeting cards, platypus candy, platypus hats, platypus back scratchers, platypus jewelry, platypus figurines for the mantelpiece, platypus cuddly toys, t-shirts with amusing platypus slogans, and music cartridges with platypus noises.
Well stocked.
I take it you're into platypuses.
I take it you're into platypuses.
Sure looks like it, huh? Platypuses are my livelihood. If you know where to find them, you can make a small fortune off of them.
By selling back scratchers to tourists?
Ha! You have no idea. For one thing, I supply them to the platypus restaurant. I'm also a bookmaker for platypus betting and chairman of the platypus club. Platypuses even inspire my poetry.
You write poetry about platypuses?
Yep, mainly for greeting cards, but they also appear every week in Platypus Daily.
Have you got anything that's not made from platypuses?
Have you got anything that's not made from platypuses?
Well, the platypus figurines are made of clay, but I use platypus wax for the finish.
Tell me more about these greeting cards.
Tell me more about these greeting cards.
It's poetry. Platypus poetry.
So when you've got the time.
So when you've got time, I'd really like you to recite some of your poetry.
Well, Buckle up, then. Here comes the classic now. I am here. There are you. Platypool.
Wow. I suddenly feel so...
inspired? Elated? Moved?
Sick.
You also supply the platypus restaurant?
You also supply the platypus restaurant?
Yep. There's good eating on one of those things.
What if there's a shortage?
Now that would be a disaster. The restaurant would have to completely change its menu. But it'll never come to that. There are unguarded nests everywhere on the floating black market.
What do you mean by unguarded nests?
What do you mean by unguarded nests?
In every generation, there's an especially vicious platypus that guards the nest of the bride.
What could they possibly do to you? Try to bite your fingers?
Let me tell you, they're evil little critters.
Oh, don't tell me they can bite through gloves.
And jock straps.
Oh.
So you're interested in nest guardians. Club members get to read all about them in the Platypus Field Guide.
Yippee!
Mababadtrip si Two Fishmers dito kung pwede siya magpunta sa depot niya. What's the deal with this platypus club?
What's the deal with this platypus club?
Oh, it's great. As a member, you always get brand new information from the world of platypuses delivered to your doorstep. You'll be the first to learn about the wonders of platypus procreation. And you'll know the platypus migration routes even before winter comes.
And you'll have feathers grow on your hump.
Platypuses have neither feathers nor humps. As a member of the club, you'd know that. Upon registration, every new member receives the latest edition of the Platypus Field Guide. I hid some trial membership cards in the restaurant's fortune cookies. With a little help from Dame Fortune, you might be able to join the inner circle of platypus enthusiasts.
If Dame Fortune really keeps herself busy with that kind of humbug, it explains the bad luck I've been having lately.
Dali lang guys, ha? May ayusin na, sandali. So kailangan natin ng membership card para sa Platypus ano, Platypus fan club, ganun ba yan? Okay. How can I become a member of the Platypus Club again?
How can I become a member of the Platypus Club again?
It's easy. I hid some trial membership cards in the restaurant's fortune cookies.
Really? Which once again proves that luck is relative.
What else can you tell me about platypuses?
What else can you tell me about platypuses?
Quite a lot, but that would take all day.
And nobody wants that.
If you were a member of the Platypus Club, you would be issued with a Platypus Field Guide. You could look it all up for yourself then.
Ah, yes. Life could be so beautiful.
Grab a bus, platypus.
Grab a bus, platypus.
Yes, I will, Ducky Bill.
Ano tayo fortune cookies dito somewhere?
Huh. They only have dishes made from platypus here. Lady Goal won't like that at all. I'd like to order some takeout.
Very well. Just make your choice from the menu.
Kailangan natin magpalit eh. Ito. Tapos kailangan natin palitan yan. Tanda ko paano magpalit. Tandaan mo natin shake. May 1 cent pa, kailangan 0 eh. $1.5 pa rin. Kailangan talaga mag-zero eh. Tignan ko na naman yung pattern. Ayan. So ito kailangan natin eh. Tapos kailangan ko ng guide. Teka. Dali lang guys. Basahin ko yung guide. Okay. Kailangan ko ng guide talaga guys eh. Nahirap, nalilito ako eh. Smallest one. Two burgers. Okay. Tapos exchange natin ito sa malaki. Tapos exchange ito sa soda. Tapos exchange natin yung soda para wala.
Is this your order?
Yes. Why?
Right. That comes to, zero zloty.
That deserves a large tip. Let's say 30%.
How very generous.
And you can keep the change. I can't wait to see if my proverbial tinkerer's luck has landed me a trial membership in the Platypus Club. The greatest happiness is to see others smile. Darn it, another loser. I'd like to order the same again.
One usual, coming up.
Never touch stuff that some stranger has already had in here. This crankshaft without a crank is missing something.
What? Okay. Ito, meron tayo
na. A crank! This crankshaft without a crank was missing a crank! Rufus, you are a genius. Caution is required. The colorful ones like to bite back. Oh man, that was a lousy Easter. I never touch stuff that some stranger has already had in their mirror.
Huwag naman natin galawin yan. May bahay dapat dito somewhere.
What an ugly nest. It must belong to an extremely ugly bird.
May egg na naman dun. Tab full of dirt.
Terrific. Even more filth.
Ande, tatamaan natin.
A rake. That could be useful. Ow!
Sabi ko kunin mo eh. Never mind, teka. Right side. napunta. Ayun.
Whoa, impressive digs.
Ahem. Have you ever heard of Knocking?
Of course, but I find their new album too commercial.
What are you doing here? Don't you at least wipe your feet?
Not since my 8th birthday. Back then, my dad?
Rufus?
Dad! You're Captain Seagull? I...
Ahem. Your shoes, Rufus.
Oh, excuse me, sir.
Pala tatay niya.
Wow, Dad, this is really a totally radical kick-ass location. And a doormat made of real wombat. Respect.
Doormat?
Yeah, it's hanging right next to the door.
That's my Sunday coat.
Oh.
Listen, Rufus, I'm a busy man. Just tell me what brought you here and then run along and play again, okay?
Aren't you all glad to see me? I thought you went to Elysium.
Aren't you at all glad to see me?
Yes, of course I'm glad. I'm just very busy right now. If you're a good boy and let your old man finish his work, then maybe later we can go feed the seagulls.
Feed the seagulls? Are you kidding? I have important things to do.
Then it won't matter if I haven't got time for you until later, right?
Later. Later. You always say that.
I thought you went to Elysium.
I thought you went to Elysium.
Elysium?
Yes, Elysium, you know. You left me to move to Elysium. You can't tell me you don't remember that.
Oh, right. Yes, I remember, and how. Just what was I thinking? After all, everybody knows that it's impossible to escape Deponia. What a wild and crazy guy I was back then. Always reaching for the stars. Today, I know it's not worth the effort to pursue such crazy ideas. Once you're as old as your dad, I'm sure you'll understand.
You can so totally forget that. I'll never be that old, loser.
You changed your name?
You changed your name?
Nothing to do with you, honestly. But still, please don't go around telling everybody you're my son, all right?
But how come you're talking to me like that?
Dad, how come you're talking to me like that? You may not have noticed, but I am no longer a child.
Ah, you're all grown up now.
Yeah, ha.
Like with a house of your own and a steady income.
Well, I mean, that's,
I'll take that for a no.
I'm a tinkerer. I even had a real workshop in Kuvak.
You're not talking about that toy workbench I once gave you when you were little.
Well, I'm still way more grown up than you are. So there.
So I... Don't you even want to know what I've been up to all this time?
Don't you even want to know what I've been up to all this time?
Oh, please don't tell me you wreaked some sort of havoc again. What was it this time? Did you set something on fire? Did you steal anything? Destroy someone else's property?
Well, I mean, you've got to see that in context.
I have stopped the Organon from blowing up Deponia.
I have to stop the Organon from blowing up Deponia.
Then what are you doing here in the floating black market? The Organon are far away. And if anything should explode here, it'll probably be your fault.
Yeah, you just don't understand.
I don't? So when has the Organon ever blown up anything?
Maybe not so far, but...
And how many detonations have you caused this month?
Well, I...
That shuts you up, huh?
I'm still counting.
Checkmate. I need to go look after my Elysian girlfriend.
I need to go look after my Elysian girlfriend.
Yes, of course. What was her name again? Babsy Boo?
No, not Babsy Boo. She's a true Elysian. Her name is Goal.
Wait a minute. Are you serious?
Now you're impressed, huh?
You meet an Elysian and then bring her here? Didn't I teach you anything?
No. You were a great parent.
You didn't leave her alone, did you?
Don't worry, she's in a safe place, down in Gulliver's Tavern at the harbor.
Okay, looks like I failed to teach you a few essential facts of life.
Really, Dad, let's not go there. I know all about the bees and the flowers, although I may be a little unclear about the concept of pollination. But I'm a real pro when it comes to building hives, if you know what I mean.
You're giving me hives, all right. But let's get back on topic. What I was trying to say is that obviously you never learned how to treat a lady. Have you at least invited her to dinner?
Well, there was this bowl of peanuts.
I'm talking about a date, Rufus. A romantic date. The only restaurant that might be suitable is Shea Schlumpy. At least they offer an exclusive view. But alas, all they have on their menu is platypus.
What's wrong with platypus?
It's so vulgar. It lives among the flotsam and feeds on table scraps. It could even be the heraldic beast of Deponia. No, platypus dishes would only remind her that she is stranded in the boondocks. You must see to it that platypus completely disappears from the menu at Schlumpy's. Can you do that?
Ah, piece of cake for a romantic like me.
Once you've done that, you may reserve a table in my name. But not before then. Understand?
Okay, nice. I haven't told you half of it.
I haven't told you the half of it.
Oh my, Rufus. What else have you gotten yourself into?
I'm actually about to go to Elysium.
Good luck.
I'm serious. I'm going to Elysium.
Yeah, right. Come on, Rufus. I am truly flattered that you want to follow in my footsteps. But do you really have to step into every single pile of poop on the way?
Not everyone. For one thing, I would never leave my 8-year-old son behind.
Really? So you would take him along?
Yes, I would.
Well, if he takes after you, I hope you'll remember to bring a little shovel and a plastic bag.
I'll tell you some other time.
Sounds good to me. In the meantime, I'll consult my legal advisor.
What exactly are you doing? Are you working on?
What exactly are you working on?
I need to write instructions for my staff.
And you consider that more important than talking to your son? We haven't seen each other in years.
So why would every second suddenly count now? I am responsible for this house and its personnel.
I am also responsible for doing important things, like saving the world.
Then why are you still hanging around here? Do I still have to hover over you to make sure you're completing your chores?
About the date.
Stop hemming and hawing and stand up straight, boy. What do you want to know?
What was it again that I need to do so you'll let me reserve a table?
The platypus dishes must be taken off the menu. I don't care how you do it.
Deal.
Just promise me that nobody will be injured in the process.
Too late. I already said deal.
Don't go away. I'll be back.
Don't
soon.
Go away. I'll be back soon.
Forget that line. Not even an 8-year-old would buy it.
Goldfish bowl.
This is no luxury villa. There's even parasites nesting here.
That is my aquarium. I collect rare ornamental fish.
Rarely significant, maybe. And they're tiny, too.
I should actually feed them again. I need breadcrumbs. There. Here, Rufus. Be so good and take this memo to the servant's mailbox.
Yeah, who does he think he is? Well, he is my... Oh, whatever. Anyway, I'm not his errand boy. I need bread.
Pwede ba nating interactan?
Hands off the ornamental fish.
Hey, I just wanted to pet them.
I said no.
Aw, man.
Tatay pala ni... Buhay pa pala yung tatay ni Rufus. Mailbox. Saan yung mailbox? Ayan. unknown area.
My botanical expertise tells me that this here is a plant.
Hey, hands off the tree!
Okay. What? That wasn't my hands. Because I did it with my feet. You see? Here, feet! Boom! Oh, come on! That was funny!
Hello!
What happened? And why does my back suddenly feel like somebody scratched the word revenge into it with a rusty rake? Ugh, must be the stress.
Hold on, the gardener.
Who looks so ferocious. But of course, it's Hoedown the Garden Gnome.
Hoedown, Hoedown, ugly as can be.
The birdhouse yan, hindi man mailbox eh.
Hey, hands off the tree!
Oh. Eh, dito muna tayo sa Ananta.
That is so pitiful. I don't know if I should laugh or cry. I'll try laughing. Oh, yeah. Good decision. That is so pitiful. I don't know if I should laugh or cry. I'll try laughing. Oh, yeah. Good decision.
Hey, hands off! If you're looking for someone who's got stuff to spare, go to Seagull. I only have things I really need.
Trained the poet.
What is that? A message from Captain High and Mighty? You can keep it. I don't need any of the stuff he needs.
Well, this message may interest you much more.
What? Show me. I need bread. Damn!
He needs bread.
I read that.
And you have bread.
Yes. But I...
Well?
I don't need that sort of thing. Go ahead and take it if you want it.
You can bet on it.
Yeah. Cool.
That is so pitiful. I don't know if I should laugh or cry. I'll try laughing. Oh, yeah. Good decision. And what's this?
The ashes of my poor mother. I keep them as a reminder.
What is a pot of ashes supposed to remind you of?
Not to feed fire platypuses dry kibble, for example.
Oh.
Hey, hands off! The ashes of my poor mother.
I thought you only had things you really need here, and that doesn't look absolutely essential.
I said, hands off!
Why does everybody always say that? That is so pitiful. I don't know if I should laugh or cry. I'll try laughing. Oh, yeah. Good decision. Knock, knock.
Who or what are you?
They call me Rufus.
They call me Rufus.
I'm Crane, but everybody here calls me the poet.
Who calls you that? I mean, I just heard it for the first time.
You probably move in the wrong circles.
Oh, yeah? If you mean those circles that don't include your ego, you're probably right.
That's what I'm talking about.
Your place looks a bit austere.
Your place looks a bit austere.
I've got everything I need.
Yeah, except for an interior designer.
Do you know Captain Seagull?
Do you know Captain Seagull?
You mean the idiot who lives above me in the villa? I'm rather fed up with him.
Hey, be careful what you say. Seagull is my father.
I see. A chip off the old block.
But you must admit that Captain Seagull has a cool lifestyle.
But you've got to admit that Captain Seagull has a cool lifestyle.
Useless and materialistic. I don't need any of the stuff he needs.
What was that again? You don't need any of the stuff that Captain Seagull needs?
What was that again? You don't need any of the stuff that Captain Seagull needs?
That's what I said.
Huh.
Can I borrow some of your things?
Can I borrow some of your things?
What else do you want?
You're such a pathetic wretch.
You're such a pathetic wretch.
But I'm rich in spirit.
Isn't that the same?
The Organon is planning to blow up Deponia.
The Organon is planning to blow up Deponia.
Ha! Typical. Those up there do whatever they want.
Were you even listening? They want to blow up Deponia. Nobody will survive. Don't you want to do anything about that?
But of course. I shall write a cynical poem. I shall call it, They Think There's Something Better.
And this poem is supposed to inspire the masses to rise up?
Not really. The masses are always too stupid for my intellectual flights of fancy.
See you later.
See you later.
Right. Leave me alone.
Sige, bigyan natin yung bread.
Hey, Dad.
What is it now? Can't you see your old man is busy?
I haven't told you half of it. About it. Don't go away.
Don't go away. I'll be back soon.
Forget that line. Not even an 8-year-old would buy it.
Okay.
Hands off the ornamental fish.
Aw, man.
Okay, fine. Okay, at least wala na yung rake. Pwede ko na ito.
This spade knows how to behave better than that darn rake. I've got enough loose dirt in my coat. If I need more soil, I should look for an appropriate container.
Okay, for now, wag naman na.
I never touch stuff that some stranger has already had in their room.
Okay. For now, dito muna tayo end na natin. So, na-meet natin yung tatay ni Rufus. Save natin. Menu tas enter natin for now. So, Kersh and Velasa signing off, guys. Tuloy na lang ulit natin to next episode.